हेलो एवरीवन, सो वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल लर्निंग विद प्रोफेसर। सो दिस इज द थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ बिल्डिंग चार्ट विद टैब्लू। सो इन दिस पर्टिकुलर वीडियो वी लर्निंग अबाउट फोर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ चार्ट इन टैब्लू। सो दैट आर गैंट चार्ट, द बुलेट चार्ट डायग्राम एंड द हीट मैप इन मच मोर डिटेल फ्रॉम स्क्रैच। सो देयर इज अ लॉट टू अनपैक इन दिस वीडियो। इफ यू आर न्यू टू दिस चैनल एंड डोंट नो मी, सो माय नेम इज आदित्य एंड डू सब्सक्राइब टू माय चैनल एज इट हेल्प मी अ लॉट as it helped me and my channel to grow. So you are the guys who can support me. So let's get started. So in the previous video, we have learned these four charts. So in this particular video, so let's start with the Gantt chart first. So let me head over to presentation. So this is how a Gantt chart look. So Gantt chart basically is used to show a timeline. If you want to show a timeline, like if you're working in an IT industry and this is our team, and in our team there are different members who have different responsibilities. So in this particular example, we have three projects, like project 1, project 2 and project 3. Okay, so if you want to see how our project 1 timeline is there, so we can see the project 1, like Dan is responsible for project 1. Dan is responsible to start the project from the month of December, and after completing his task, he has to hand it over to Ted after 1st January. It is handed over to Ted for the remaining work, if you can see from this timeline. So this is how we interpret Gantt chart and we get detailed. So this is very useful in an organization, and it is also useful in many other scenario where you want to show a timeline. So let's deep dive into Tableau and see how to build a Gantt chart for our particular case and what we can visualize. So let me open Tableau first. So the first step you know is like select the order sheet and drag it to right hand side. Okay, so this is our order sheet has been loaded. So these are all the features which are available in a data set, and this is the data type which is denoted to each of the features, like row ID is a number, order ID is a calendar, and region is also categorical. So this is how we interpret the fields. So let me head over to new sheet. So the first step is to change the mark option to a Gantt bar option. After that, let me show you what are the different ship modes. So you can see there are first class, same day shipped, second class and standard class. So I want to see if we order different subcategory, so what is the lag time for different classes. So let me start building it. So we want to see the order date and we want to see it weekly wise. So we'll just click on this drop down and click on week number. Perfect. So now what I want is I want to see the subcategory, how the subcategory has been ordered bi weekly. So these are the subcategories and this is the order. It looks messy now, but we will clean this up. So now what we want to see the ship mode. Okay, so let me drag the ship mode to rows. Yeah, so you can see for SLs. Yeah, so now what I can do is now I can just drag the ship mode to colors. Yeah, so now it is perfect, but now it is showing a lot of noise is there. So I'll just drag the week of order date into filter, control click and drag it to filter. Then select the range of dates. Suppose I want to see the data. So I want to see the date from 1st of January to 1st of March. So I'll just select this column and just, okay. Now the main thing, so now it is almost done. So now the main thing which you want is, we want to see the duration, like how much time it is taking if we are ordering with first class, second class, standard class. So we need to create a calculated field. So don't worry much if you don't know about calculated field. So in this, so we will cover calculated field in much more detail in the next video. So how to create a calculated field is, you can just click on this drop down here and we can click calculated field. So calculated fields are nothing, the data which is available to us, we are calculating a new field with the help of this existing data, that is known as calculated field. So suppose I am creating a calculated field for number of days to be shipped. How much time it takes to ship. So what I can do is in the calculate field, on the right hand side you can see different formulas. So in this, what I am doing is I'm just using date diff, like date difference, and I want to get the day. So you can see date part. So I want to get the day. So I'll just add day. Then we have the detail for order date and the ship date. So if you minus ship date to order date, then we will get how much day is there. Just a simple calculation. So I'll just select order date, comma, ship date. So what this formula will do is it will just calculate the day with using order date and ship date to produce the day. So just click OK. And after, so now it is calculated, so it is a measure, so it is coming in the down. So now what we can do is just drag this calculated field into size. Perfect. So now you can see our Gantt chart is ready. So you can see for the first, for SSIs, for the first class, the number of days to ship it takes is 8 days, and if it is the second class, it takes only 2 days. So for, from this timeline, we can see what is the lag for different classes, how our order is lagging. So this is the way we can interpret Gantt chart. So now let us understand about bullet chart. So before deep dive into bullet chart, let me explain you with the help of simple example. So let us consider we have a shop, The Joy of Chai, which sell tea and coffee, okay, at America. So what we want to see is we want to visualize the sales number. So one way of doing is it, we can represent the sales number in the form of line chart, because it is the best suitable option. Okay, and if we have like this much should be a, if we have some target, like this much sales we should target for this week, or this much we should achieve. So what we can do is we can visualize in the form of a KPI, or the benchmark we want to set for the sales number, or you can say the target variable, any one thing, those target, KPI or benchmark is same for sales. Okay, so what we want is we don't want to visualize in a form of line graph. So what we can do is we can also visualize this in a form of bar chart. So what we can do is, so we can just represent the sales number, how our sales going, in the form of bar chart for different years. Suppose this is 2020, this is 2021, this is 2022. This is representing by a bar chart. So what we can do is, like as we are representing the KPI in a line chart, the same way if we represent the KPI with a bar chart. So if we represent this KPI, like suppose the sales number should be around 50, okay, so this is how we are representing, like 50 for this, 50 for this year, and 50 for this year. So this form of representation is known as bullet chart, okay, where we are showing the KPI with the bar graph. This form is known as, so let me show you how a real bullet chart look like. So this is how a bullet chart will look like. So you can see this is the sales which we are visualizing in our data, and the dark color line represent the actual value. This represent the actual value, okay, and this is our benchmark, or we can say as the KPI, okay, and this quantitative band is nothing, just means how we want to see our data. Suppose you want to see the target sales as a percentage, like you want to see if our sales has achieved 30% of the target or 40% of the target. So this is how we give distribution band in bullet chart. Don't worry much, we will see all this live in action in Tableau. So let me jump to Tableau now. There's a coffee store data set. So in this, there are different products such as espresso, herbal tea, coffee. So we want to visualize the sales number. Okay, so let me jump to sheet 1 and rename it as bullet chart. Okay, so now what I want is, I want state wise what is the sales and what is the budget sales, that is the target sales. Okay, so if I select these three measures and dimension, and I just click on show me button, so it will show me what are the types of graph which are best suitable for this case. So for this case, I'm just going to draw this a bullet graph. Okay, perfect. So now just one thing I need to do is just right click on this x-axis and swap the reference line field. Perfect. So now it has taken the reference for the एवरेज बजट सेल्स। ओके सो दिस इज हाउ वी ड्रॉ बुलेट चार्ट इन टैबलू। सो नाउ लेट मी शो यू इंडिविजुअल स्टेप लाइक हाउ टू क्रिएट अ बुलेट चार्ट फ्रॉम स्क्रैच विदाउट डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द शो मी बटन। सो वट वी कैन डू इज द फर्स्ट वी वॉन्ट टू शो इज स्टेट वाइज सेल्स। सो वट वी कैन डू इज लाइक वी कैन जस्ट ड्रैग द सेल्स टू द रो शेल्फ एंड स्टेट टू द कॉलम शेल्फ। परफेक्ट। एंड नाउ वट वी कैन डू इज स्वैप द एक्सिस। सो हियर इज द ऑप्शन फॉर स्वैपिंग द एक्सिस। परफेक्ट। सो नाउ आर बार चार्ट इज रेडी। सो नाउ वट आई वॉन्ट इज I want to show the KPI here, sales number. So what I can do is, first of all, the first step is we need to drag our budget sales in detail. So we can draw a reference line in it. Okay. So now what we can do is we can go to analytics tab and just reference line to sell. And here we can select the sum of budget sales and we want to see the average. Okay, and these are the all the adjustments we can do if we want to show the label. So we can show the label here, but in this case we are not going to show any label, and we can do custom also if you want to do. So now just click on okay. Okay, so now what is remaining is now in this we have seen the qualitative bands. So in the tab we will add the bands. So what we can do is we will add the distribution band on the cells, just drag the distribution band to cells. Perfect. So now you can select the percentage you want to show. Suppose I want to show if our sales number is doing 50% of our average value and 75% of our average value. So what I can do is I can just select 50 and 75 percentile of the budget sales and do it by average. Perfect. And just click fill above. So now we can see this is a bullet. So now let us see how to build a histogram in Tableau. So what we can do is, suppose I want to see the profit distribution. So what I can do is I can just click on this drop down profit and just create a bin. So it will show what is the size of bin you want to take. So this is the size of bin which is already taken. So I will not make any changes in that. So you can make changes according to your wish. I can click on OK. So you can see a dimension has been created for profit bin. So what now we have to do is just we have to drag the profit bin to the column shelf. Perfect. So now I want to see the product type. Okay, so for seeing the frequency what I want is the count. So what I can do is I can just drag the product type to row shelf and I can just click on this and it will measure as count. Perfect. So this is our profit distribution according to various product types. So this is histogram. So now let us jump toward the heat map. So heat map are basically used when we want to represent our measure as a density. Suppose you want to show the temperature for Central Park, New York, and we are representing it with the help of colors for different intensity. If it is represented by red color, so that means it has a hot temperature. And if it is representing by green color, it means it is a cold temperature, and for yellow it is a moderate temperature. So we can get the inference from this graph is like for the month of May to September the weather is quite hot, and for the month of January to February the weather is cold, and in the March it is getting toward moderate, and after that it is getting to hot situation, and after that it is again in October month it is moderate, and after in December it is the cold temperature. So this is how we can get an inference from a heat map. It is very useful when you want to represent a certain measure with the help of density using colors. So let me rename the sheet as heat map. So now what I want to see is, suppose I want to see state wise, or suppose I want to see subcategory wise and region wise, what are the profit, like which subcategory is making profit in which region. So what I can do is I can just drag the profit to the color shelf. Perfect. So now our heat map is almost ready. So now what I want to see is I want to see in an entire view. Perfect. Now what I can do is I can just change the color, and I want to represent the ones subcategory which is going on losses to represent it by red color. Okay, and the one which is making sales, like which is making a good number of profit, to be represented by a green color. Perfect. Just click on apply. Okay, yeah, so now our heat map is ready. So you can see like a table subcategory is going on losses, and supplies are having less profit, and the copiers and the phones are having more profit. For this case, this might be not a good way to represent in a heat map, but just to give an essence of heat map and how to build a heat map, I have just taken this. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you guys enjoyed going through this video and you learned something from it. And if you're new to this channel, then do subscribe to my channel, Learning with Professor, as it helped me a lot and my channel to grow. And in the next video, we'll be covering about different types of filters in Tableau. And if you have any doubts regarding any of the content in the video, you can just feel free to write in the comment section below. I will just try to give the answer for the following doubts you have. So see you soon next time.